Hello everyone, we're gonna get into costing. Yes, this will be series, probably big series. So we gotta do it, it's Business Central. I know I've gotten some costing videos on NAV 2017, 18, 16 maybe. But we're gonna do it for Business Central. It's gonna be similar. So what am I gonna attack first? Let's keep it simple. In the beginning, we have an item. This is actually going to be a coffee mug spring version because we're waiting for spring here in New York City. And we're going to buy it, so it's going to be put on a purchase order. And we're going to start by receiving it and not invoice it. So in Business Central, you can actually receive the product in. So you got the inventory into the warehouse, but you haven't received the invoice yet. So the inventory can start moving around in the warehouse, even be sold, and then the invoice comes in later. And what we want to do is take a look at how that actually posts. So what happens when you do receive, not invoice, and then later you do invoice. So what do these two steps do? And technically what happens here is that on the item itself, when you receive, there is an item ledger entry that gets created, one, for the receipt. And it has the document number of the receipt, okay? And then that item ledger entry is basically telling you the inventory transaction, what, from a quantity standpoint, what happened to the quantity? Quantity came in. There's an item ledger entry for that. So what about the value? So there will be a cost amount here. How much the value of this item ledger entry is. And that's gonna be zero in the beginning when you hit receive, not invoice, because you haven't invoiced yet. You don't know the cost. So it starts out by being zero. And then when you invoice, it turns into being, and I think we're gonna go with like 500 or something like that. So it changes from zero to 500. How can it change? Well, we have value entries, remember, underneath, right here. So in the beginning, there's a value entry that has a value of zero for the receipt. And then later, when you invoice, there's another value entry that gets created for 500. And this cost up here is the sum, and I'm using fancy math signs now, of all of this, of the value entries. So that's this. as we know from item charges, if you watch that video. So let's see how that's in Business Central. Let's check it out. Okay, so what we want to do is to receive, not invoice, on an item. Let me go ahead and get into the item list. And we have here the spring coffee mug, which I just created. And that has no transactions, and it's FIFO costing method. So we're going to be exploring FIFO, and it's the inventory posting group is here, resale. So we're going to see how that actually posts into the system. I'm just going to close that out and create a purchase order. And we get in here, create a new purchase order to Fabricum. And I want to post it today's date. So I'm going to put T here, this is 315, and it's going to be the spring coffee mug right here. I want to put it into the main location. We're going to get 100 pieces in. I'm going to pay $5 for each, and we're just going to receive it, not invoice it. So I can go into post here, hit receive, hit OK, and now the quantity to receive goes into quantity received right here. But quantity to invoice stays. So I haven't invoiced yet. So we have this two-step process. And now what happens if I actually just receive it and do not invoice it? What is the transaction that comes through? Let's take a look at that. So if I go into the items again and take a look at the item ledger entry for this. So go here into navigate history entries, ledger entries. So we have a purchase right here. And the cost amount is coming in as zero because we haven't booked anything. And it's just 100 coming in. Now, if I navigate on this, I see like that. Then that's, whoops. Oh, okay. Navigate gets thrown out in an error. That's a first. So let's go back. Oh, that's really odd. Oops. Don't want to be in the sandbox. Let's try this again. Go into items. And the spring coffee mug. Go into navigate, history, and trees, letter entries. And we do process navigate. Okay, that's better. That was odd. Got thrown off there a little bit. So here we have a posted purchase receipt, item ledger entry, and value entry. So there are no GL entries that got created. So basically, as we received, it did generate inventory, but did not post anything to the GL. So let's go ahead and invoice. So let's go ahead and get it to the purchaser. Like so, and get to the last one, which was the one we wanted. We put in the invoice number, ABC 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so done. Hit post, and so you see quantity to invoice right here is already 100. So I just go ahead and post, and now I'm gonna invoice. And it should now put in the $500. So close it out, go back. Go into the items, and hopefully it will not bomb out on us. That was odd, that's what happened before. Get into navigate, history, entries, ledger entries. Now we have cost 500. Let's hit process navigate. So now actually, and this is interesting. We have these entries now because that's focusing on the receipt and not the invoice. The invoice is a different document number. If I take out the document number and let's see, find, it wants to find by document, so that's fine. Let's just get out of it. And if we scroll actually into the cost, you can see that there are two documents. This is the receipt document, what we posted first. And this is the invoice document. So right now what I did, I scrolled into the cost, or drilled into the cost. and so you can see here, the cost is actually posted on the invoice, not on the receipt. There's no cost posted on the receipt. Cost is posted on the invoice. And if I go ahead and let me see if I can navigate on this one. And I'm in the value entries now. Now I get the GL entries, and I can see how that actually posts through. So if I click on the GL entries, I can see that it's posting 500 onto, see, it actually hits direct cost right here. So it's 2100, and then, which is a vendor account, probably be the AP, and then it's hitting asset accounts here, which is inventory. And actually it's going in and out of this here direct cost. It's all in the same account. So, and there's a reason why it actually generates four entries. And this is something that I wanted to get into maybe a little bit further in further videos. But from a simple standpoint, what it's basically doing is posting to AP 500 because we owe the vendor 500. And posting to asset 500 because we have inventory of 500. And that does not happen until you actually invoice. because nothing happens when you actually receive and not invoice. So it's important that those are two steps. And they actually are visualized here in the value entries.